Dear friends, I have some very interesting information to bring to your attention regarding the Bendigo Mosque. Now, this is very important. On the 10th of October, I was one of the guest speakers who was invited by the people of Bendigo to address a gathering of more than 1,000 people who opposed the building of the mosque in Bendigo. Now, I want to take some time and read this. Please listen in, because this is your future, our country's future. We just got to be careful what we're letting into the country. 1,000 people gathered to say, we don't want the mosque in the community. In breaking news, newspapers there in the Australian, Hamas Charity linked to mosque in Bendigo. So who are the people behind the Bendigo Mosque? When the presentation was given on Channel 7, there were two very nice, simple, smiling Muslims presented as very peaceful people who were involved in the mosque. But is there more to that what meets the eye? The Herald Sun has a caption, but who are these people behind the Bendigo Mosque? The fight over the Bendigo Mosque is more complicated than the story usually presented in the media of anti-Islam bigots and simply a bunch of Muslim people who want to pray. So all this is like, those who stand up for their country are considered to be extremists, while those who want to destroy the country seem to be the nice boys in town. That's how the media sensationalize it. But now you be the judge as I read this information. The proposed mosque by Australian Islamic Mission to build a $3 million mosque in rural Bendigo has already attracted an unsavory crowd of protesters. But that may not be the worst of it. Some of the people associated with AIM, Australian Islamic Mission, are so extreme they have been denied visas to the US and the UK. Now come on. What is the Australian government doing about this? If some of these people are so extreme, their visas have been banned from the UK and the US, is the Australian government going to permit an organization such as this to fund $3 million to build a mosque? When they put in $3 million to build a mosque, you mean to say they're not going to have the same birds of the same feather which are going to come together there? Don't you think that these guys could be, or the people who will be teaching the people in Bendigo, the Muslims, even if they are innocent Muslims, to be radicalized by the Quran? For AIM's 2014-2015 conferences, the leading speaker was Dr. Anas Al-Tariqi, founder of the Cordoba Foundation, UK. In August 2009, the Cordoba Foundation sponsored an event with Imam Anwar Al-Walaki, a senior recruiter for Al-Qaeda, who was killed in a drone strike in 2011. Just see the connections. Al-Awalaki preached to three of the 9/11 hijackers, correspondent with Nidal Malik Hassan, before the army psychiatrist went on a shooting rampage. This is the guy who went on a shooting rampage, the army guy in the US in Fort Hood, and was linked to Umar Farooq Abdulalab, who tried to blow up the US airliner. It's very interesting, friends. These guys are no small fish. They are big time Islamic terror activists. Another speaker at the AIM 2014 conference was Yvonne Ridley, an activist with the UK Respect Party. Ridley called the Chechen architect of the Beslan School massacre a martyr. You remember the Beslan School massacre, where little children were gunned down, innocent children, 7, 8, 9 year olds. That guy was called a martyr. In June 2010, Dr. Tariq Al-Sulaywadan was the guest speaker at an AIM fundraiser dinner. In May 2007, was listed as a member of the US Muslim Brotherhood an indicated conspirator and or joint venturer in a case between U.S. District Court, Dallas Division, and the Holy Land Foundation of the Relief of Development. In 2008, the founder of HLF was found guilty of channeling $12 million to Hamas. Come on, this organization had channeled $12 million to Hamas, and now those links are connected to building the mosque in Bendigo? Come on, you're going to tell me these guys are not going to preach violence against the non-Muslims in the town and in the nation? This is a recipe for disaster. Rise up, Australia. Last year, Al Sulaiman was banned from attending a Muslim fair in Brussels after he said he's one of their speakers, sponsored by AIM, was banned to enter Brussels because he said this. Israel, we hate them. That's what this guy said. They are our enemies. We should instill this in the souls of our children until a new generation arises and wipes them off the face of the earth. Each and every one of us, when leaving this hall, should be contemplating a plan how to wipe out Israel. This guy actually told the people or made statements to that effect, saying Israel needs to be wiped out. If anyone says that, we should not tolerate them anywhere in the country. So we know the Quran says the Jews are considered to be pigs, and we don't tolerate that nonsense. And this is the AIM which is giving $3 million to the Bendigo Mosque? Come on. The Secretary of AIM Melbourne, Dr. Siddiqui, said AIM invited the speaker because he was popular but did not endorse his views 100%. Oh yeah, a speaker who promotes violence, a speaker who says get rid of the Jews, banned in so many countries, AIM invites him because he's very popular. What is he popular of? Calling on jihad against infidels? It's time to stand up. There's nothing moderate, however, about the video AIM Victoria shared on its Facebook page, which shows a picture of Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu with the sound of a gunshot firing, and a photo apparently former Israel Defense Minister Ehud Barak with a rifle sight over face and the sole of a gun firing and sound of a gun firing. Stay there with me. This is important information. AIM Victoria's Facebook page also shared a photo of Fahd al-Sadaka by Sheikh Yusuf al-Qurabi, sorry for the pronunciation of some of the names, they are a bit hard to pronounce, with the exhortation of read to understand. Friends, it's time that the people of Australia wake up. If AIM, Australian Islamic Mission, is putting in $3 million for the mosque in Bendigo, there has to be much more than what meets the eye. Because you can't but help expect radical views of Islam, which is true Islam, taught in that mosque. No wonder somehow someone above has watched over the city of Bendigo and helped us stand up against this particular mosque. Let's unite together. As the national president of Rise Up Australia Party, I want to challenge every Australian to rise up, to keep Australia Australian for generations to come.